Hi guys, I'm here to talk to you about one thing, and that one thing is movies. Yeah, cut. I'm looking at a script. And every movie starts with a script. And that script is built upon ideas, and those ideas come from one person from multiple places. Alright. Hi guys, I'm here to talk to you about one thing, and that one thing is movies. Come on, with all the things to talk about in the world, you choose movies? Yes. You know what? I think I'm gonna write a script. And I'm gonna call that script Good Will Hunting. Brilliant, that is the most brilliant idea in the world. Okay, now who's gonna be in this movie? Okay, I'm gonna play the main character of Will. Okay, that's already established because I'm writing it in, And I'm gonna get Robin Williams because this is a serious movie and he's more of a, you know, comedic actor, so it's gonna kind of play well because I want this to be funny, but I want it to be serious. Oh, and I'm gonna be a janitor because janitors are awesome, so I'm gonna play a janitor. And I'm going to be very smart because, let's face it, I'm not really the smartest person alive. So I'm going to be smart and, I'm going to get a girl and she's got to be British, actually, because that's more hot, draw in the masses, you know what I mean? And there's going to be a lot of sexual innuendo and I've got the screenplay like already mapped out and yeah. That's great. Oh, one more thing. I gotta win an Oscar for this, or else I just gotta win an Oscar. Oh, and I'm gonna bring that idiot Ben Affleck around, you know. I kinda promised him that we'd be, you know, in a movie together, we'd write a movie together because we're best friends and it's like kinda cliche. So if the Academy knows that, then it will boost our chances. Oh, and I'm gonna write most of the screenplay because, yeah, it was my idea. Hi guys, sorry I'm late, but the service at Starbucks was horrendous. Okay, you guys know, I walk in, and I get my usual, and I walk out, and that's the way it should be, but no, I walk in, and I'm like, you know what, I'll have a large. And the lady's like, you mean a venti? And I'm like, no, I'll have a large. And she continues to say, you mean a venti? And I'm like, I'm steaming at this point. I'm like, no, I don't want a venti, I want a large. And she's like, a large is a venti. Get that through your thick skull. And then I realize, I haven't been going to Starbucks this whole time. I've been going to freaking Dunkin' Donuts the whole time. And I was so confused. And I walked out of there like, I just caused a scene in Starbucks. This is going to end up on TMZ tomorrow night. Okay, without further ado. Alright, so this, we need to come up with the next hit movie, and we need to come up with it fast. So any ideas? Yes, what's your idea? Vampires and werewolves. That is brilliant. Where'd you come up with that idea? Oh, it's a book. Okay, let me write down the name of the book. Twilight. And who's it by? Okay. And can anyone get this Stephanie Meyer on the phone, let's say, in an hour or so? Okay, you're in charge of that. Alright. So, we're gonna come up with the script. It's gonna be done by tomorrow. And then I'm thinking we'll film on Friday. And the movie will be out next week. And that way, you know, we make some money. And if this doesn't hold out, if this doesn't work out the way it should, then, you're fired. And you're fired too because I just don't like you. I don't even know your name. What's your name? Okay, Jim, I don't like you. I just hate you. Okay, now somebody get me a venti before I cry right now. Now, as you can see, that was pretty pathetic. You know? And movies will come out, like, every month, and they'll have ridiculous trailers. And these trailers will say something like, from the producer of Bridesmaids comes The Heat. And you're like, oh my god, the producer of Bridesmaids made The Heat. Oh my god, I love see The Heat and it's like terrible and you're like, who's the producer again? Now, another thing people do when they make movies is they mislead people. They put all the funniest parts of their movie into the trailer. And that upsets me because you're like, oh, well, all the funny parts in the movie were from the trailer. So if you've seen the trailer, you've seen the movie. So why go out, spend an arm and a leg just to go see that movie that's probably not even over an hour, come out of the theater like a zombie, like, that movie sucked. I don't get it, you know? So that's why I propose that we boycott going to the movies. And I know what you're saying, I could never do that. But in the end, you will see that you'll have more money in your pocket and you will be more happy. Because if I go to the movies, and this has happened in recent years, you see commercials. Now, I don't mean movie trailers before the movie, actual commercials before the movie. It's like, if I wanted to see commercials before my movie, I would have gone to my couch, sat down, watched FX, which shows movies all the time, and commercials, and I would have been happier. And I wouldn't have had to spend a dime. But it's whatever. So, in all honesty, going to the movies is actually fun. Because you get to get out of the house, you get to see a movie, and even if it's terrible, you can always make fun of it. And that's better than nothing. So I'll see you guys later, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like the video, subscribe, and comment, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.